If I bleed tonight, if I am sad tonight, I don't have a job to find. And if I work tonight, if I'm so tired tonight, I'll fall asleep when I'm home. When I'm home.
All right, here we go. Top 10 Raw Moments for August 31st, 2020.
Name?
Akira Tozawa, and these are my ninjas.
I'm sorry, sir. Your name's not on the list.
What? I'm 24/7 champion, look!
You're not on the list, sir. I'm sorry.
Gee. Boom. You can't recognize him as a referee. What am I supposed to say? Like, yeah, how many times are you gonna hit and run? How many times are you gonna hit and run? How many times? What's their point? You've already done this week after week. You're not breaking ground here with what they're doing. Same shit, different week. They didn't even show up Friday.
And this is smart tag team competition by the Hellboys. But Cedric trying to catch MVP. Oh. And he does. He pulled the tights.
I don't know what that means either.
Now Cedric Alexander and the Viking Raiders.
You're right, Joe. Cedric Alexander had the tight for Alexander.
Is he or isn't he? Is he going to get with the hurt business or not?
Super kick. Heads up.
Ever.
Oh, here we go.
Poor Dolph now is just the enhancement talent now.
Cover.
Poor Dolph.
Lee advances to the triple threat. Billy Kay trying to turn it around on Ruby Riott. Her shoulders down and a kick out. And now Ruby Riott stops up Billy Kay.
They deserve it.
The Iconics are no more.
Whoa. You're doing that like... You do that when you're pumped up, not when you're pissed.
What do you think about this? Kevin Owens is one of the...
Is that a yes?
I don't know yet, you know? It's a good thing that he's this vicious.
We saw this last week with Aleister Black, but what?
See how a heel turn works for Aleister.
See the bandaged right eye of Aleister Black and look... At the expression on Randy
this don't align those two together. That could be a hit.
Now another stop by Rollins.
The WWE can't push Dominik too much. People gonna get tired of it. I'm not, but you know, you gotta space it out. You gotta, you know, take your time. So what? Her business goes underground. And weren't they underground a few weeks ago? It's not like it's something different. From what I've seen on Twitter, the ratings are starting to go down for third hour and Raw Underground. This was a good way to keep Keith Lee strong. He didn't take the pin. Rollins can afford to take a pin. I always say he's like in a mafia. He's a made man. No matter. It's unfinished business between him and Drew, so of course they're gonna face each other. All right, Raw from the Thunderdome in the Amway Center. Now, Randy Orton kicks things off. And tonight, there will be a series of matches. Three of them will see the winners face off in a triple threat. And the winner of that match will go on to Clash of Champions to face Drew McIntyre, question mark, whether or not he'd be cleared. He had a hairline jaw fracture. First storyline, I guess. We'll see what happens now. Keith Lee versus Dolph Ziggler. KO versus Randy Orton. And Dominic, in place of his father, Ray, was injured at Payback. Dominic will go against Seth Rollins. But Orton looks heated and states that he delivered three punt kicks to McIntyre because he didn't appreciate a pity rematch. Edge, Christian, Big Show, Ric Flair, and Shawn Michaels got kicked in their skulls. And he doesn't feel he has to wrestle a singles match to go on to the triple threat to earn his title match. Orton shows a pic of all his victims laid out on hospital beds. Great Photoshop job. Love it. But Keith Lee's music hits, and he heads down the rampway to confront the Viper. Lee talks about the carnage over the last few months, but Orton seems to have forgotten that he lost to him. He lost to Keith Lee. And he got a chance to bask in his glory. And perhaps his victory over the Legend Killer should give him the opportunity to challenge for the title. But Ziggler attacks the Limitless One as Orton watches on. Keith Lee versus Dolph Ziggler. And Dolph honestly tries an attempted takedown of the much huger Lee. And even though the odds are he may not survive Lee, Dolph is able to lock in a sleeper in an attempt to wear down the much bigger Lee. Much bigger man. But a shoulder block on Dolph, and he gets pounced to the outside of the ring. This match goes back and forth, and Dolph slaps on that sleeper again, but the power game comes into play, and Keith Lee hits a power slam. But Ziggler manages to hit a zigzag and goes for a super kick, but Lee blocks it and turns it into a spirit bomb and advances to the triple threat match. Now, Nia Jax and Shayna Baszler are still at odds backstage, and Asuka saunters in, and will she tell us who will be the next challenger for her Raw Women's title? Now, she's in the ring interviewed by Charlie Caruso, and she has beaten many, and no one is ready for her, but Asuka is ready for anything. Then Mickie James comes out, and Natalya demands her shot. Okay, let's get it going, and Asuka says she is ready for all three, including Lana, who is at Natalya's side. What does this mean? I can get with Mickie challenging Asuka. She did challenge Asuka for the NXT Women's title at NXT TakeOver Toronto, shortly after she returned to WWE. Now, we got Lana versus Mickie in an impromptu match with Asuka on commentary. Well, at first you can't even hear her, Asuka. Fix her audio, guys. I love her on commentary. Mickie is in the ring, and I guess she is carrying Lana because Lana didn't look as clumsy as usual. And oh well, so much for Lana winning this match, as she is on the receiving end of a Mick kick, and James wins the match. Now, Charlie again is backstage and gets a word with Aleister Black on why he attacked KO. But strangely enough, Orton emerges from Black's dressing room. What does that mean? She's trying to get a word with Aleister. Out comes Orton. Something to it. And it's announced that the Riot Squad and the Iconics will have a number one contenders match and attack for the tag titles. And whomever loses will be no more. And the Iconics are backstage, and will they be no more after tonight? Well, we go down memory lane with them as they talk about their journey and becoming tag champs again, which will be iconic. Now, Randy Orton versus KO, the second match in the triple threat matches. Aleister comes out and attacks KO as he walks down to the ring, connecting with Black Mask. KO musters up enough strength to have the match, but gets hit with an RKO. And just like that, Orton is in the triple threat match. Now, Now we know why he was in Black's dressing room. And backstage, we see the whole Mysterio family, Rey, Dominik, Angie, and Aaliyah. Now we remember those two, Dominik and Aaliyah, when they were little. And they're grown man and woman now. And I don't know, I wonder if Aaliyah's training. There's no word about that, if she's going to be a wrestler herself. She doesn't have to be. Not every second generation person from a wrestler has to, go into wrestling. But, we'll see if that's going to be in her future. And Dominik assures Rey that there is a 619 with the Monday Night Messiah's name on it. Now the VIP lounge with the Hurt Business in ring and the new U.S. champ, Lashley. And Apollo is on their minds, and Lashley assures him he will get payback on it. And Shelton will beat him like a punk later on in the Raw Blunder Dome. Cedric Alexander heads down the ramp and he will not join the Hurt Business. Along with the Viking Raiders and Mayhem ensues. They all get a piece of each other right before their match. So we'll see how that's going to carry over. And next is the Viking Raiders and Alexander, since Cedric Alexander, versus the Hurt Business. Now, in the end, Alexander pins MVP with a roll-up and a handful of tights, and MVP is all smiles and even claps along with the Hurt Business. Perhaps a newfound respect, but after the break, and Alexander is being beat down by the Hurt Business, and Cruz and Ricochet come to Alexander's aid. Now the Riot Squad versus the Iconics, and the Riot Squad have earned a women's tag team title match as Ruby pins Billy Kay, after a series of roll-up attempts, a very rudimentary, typical match, but they all got their stuff in, and it is what it is. Now, what does this mean? Peyton can be pushed as a single star, but Billie Kay? Maybe she could be a valet or something to somebody? Maybe she can show what she can do as a solo star, single star. Who knows? Now, remember that it has been teased before. But in the end, where will these two end up landing? That's what I'm thinking. Now, Seth sends Murphy away until he figures out where he stands as a man. He's in the ring with Murphy, and because of what happened last week, we all know. And he also says that he wants to know which part of history he wants to be on. Murphy did cost them the match at Payback, and just as Murphy heads up the rampway, Dominik attacks Murphy from behind, and the match is underway. Dominik versus Rollins, and Rollins is in control, as is to be expected. He's more experienced, and Dominik needs to reach deep down if he expects to win tonight. But Dominik lost to Seth at SummerSlam, so maybe that will serve as incentive to drive him to beat the Monday Night Messiah. And Dominik does get momentum going, and it gets in some offense. It hits a 619 and sets up for a frog splash. But no water in the pool, as the saying goes. And he crashes and burns. And Seth now sets up for the stomp. He connects and pins Dominik. And Rollins moves on to face Orton and Lee in the triple threat match tonight. And to add insult to injury, Rollins hits another stomp to Dominik. This is not going to impede his momentum. He's still young in his career, and he's shown every time. That's the thing that I always say, that if these guys can show what they can do, and they could even look good losing, people are going to be behind that individual. And I think a lot of people are behind Dominik. I am. I think that I've always been following him ever since he was a kid, when he was doing those storylines with Eddie and Ray, custody battle thing. You know, we saw that whole thing, and I was just always wondering if Dominik or even Aaliyah were going to follow in their dad's footsteps. Dominik has, and he's still young, 22, 23, and he only has just a bright future ahead of him. So, we'll see what his next thing's going to be, who is he going to be going up against, if it's going to be again with Seth Rollins, but we'll see. Now, my favorite thing, Raw Blunderground, and Titus takes out one, then another, then Riddick Moss comes out and gets him some, and he gets thrown out, and they go at it, and inside the ring, Moss punches Titus's lights out. The Raw tag champs are here, and they want the smoke. You always, every time, that's what they want, every single time. And I saw in the video, Truth becomes the 39 times 24/7 champ to a 24/7 mess, 24/7 championship mess. Who cares? Honestly, who fucking cares? I don't. Now, Street Profits versus Andrade and Garza in a tornado tag team match. Now, Demi Burnett is in Garza's corner. Is she one of those girls that uses dudes for her own gains? I mean, she's kissing Ivar on the cheek, and then she goes out with Garza to the ring. But anyway, what is to be expected in these type of matches, right? It's utter chaos and mayhem all over the place. Even some double team moves like a suplex powerbomb involving all four men. Near fall after near fall, and just who wants it more? You know, who wants it more? Because whomever does will win this match. The lights flicker, and in the arena comes Retribution, who proceeds to beat on the Profits and Andrade and Zelina in the ring and at ringside. And Retribution retreat after doing their damage. There are rumors that one of them is Mia Yim. There's even talks about Dominik Dijakovic Dio, the former commentator who got knocked out of action after taking an F5 on a table that knocked some people out for a week, maybe a few days, and they came back. But he got knocked out for, 3 months? So we'll see how he does as a member, if it is him, as one of the members of Retribution. Now, again, Rob Blunderground, I even blubbered my voice. Rob Blunderground resumes, and Jessamyn Duke makes her debut and does what she does, I guess. And Marina Shafir, dressed like a grandma, gets her victory by submission. What the fuck was she wearing? You know you're going to be on TV. Rob Blunderground is taped. It's not live. So you're going to go out there looking like a grandma, like dressed like how you were dressed. Like, what were you wearing? You didn't look tough throwing that girl around, and then you had the hat right here in front of you, and you were totally like, it looked like you were having a hard time. But that's where they belong, you know, and that, you know, piece of crap Rob Blunderground. That's where they belong, because they're garbage. They can't wrestle. All this time, I went away from wrestling for about 5 months. I came back, they still looked like they hadn't even gained a step. But then Ronda Rousey in 1 year went from, you know, just green as hell, and then she was like she's like a rookie of the year kind of thing. Shayna Baszler can't do no wrong. She's excellent in the ring. None of it rubs off on those two. Now, Peyton Royce, you saw it in the video, she got thrown into the ring by Peyton, and she kind of looked like she was happy about that. She really wasn't like, oh my God, you know. I mean, at the end, yeah, sure, but not during that time. And Billy Kay, you know, she gets in the ring and she gets knocked out. Poor Billy. Now back to Raw Blunderground, and in the main event, Apollo Crews versus Shelton Benjamin. All hell breaks loose as the Hurt Business and Crews, Ricochet, and Alexander mix it up. And in the end, the Hurt Business handles business and stands tall. Now Garza is a weasel. Going back to the whole thing with the attack by Retribution, he leaves Andrade and Zelina and defend for themselves. And with Demi backstage, you know, he took her with him, right? But he leaves her as Retribution confront the two. And well, at least she ran away because she had also the smarts, I guess, too. She doesn't look as dumb as she looks. Now, triple threat match for the shot at the WWE title at Night of Champions. Night of Champions? Clash of Champions? Is it Clash of Champions or Night of Champions? Whatever it is, there's going to be some champions there. Like I was saying, triple threat match for the shot at the WWE title at Clash of Champions. Now, the Viper and the Messiah work together to take out the much bigger Lee, and well, we know that wouldn't last. An RKO attempt reversed and turned into a Falcon Arrow. Ali is an out and imposes his will and powers Orton and Rollins all over the ring and the ringside area. But a series of finisher attempts. Rollins misses a stomp, but Lee hits a spirit bomb. But Orton hits the RKO and pins Rollins, and Orton heads into the clash as the number one contender. Now, will Drew McIntyre be cleared? Will Orton finally become the WWE champion and become the champion for the 14th time? Well, that's my video. And for those of you who stopped by and checked it out, I appreciate it. And in closing, as always, take care.